I need to put this 12 amp 4.5 volts to 30 volts DC buck converter in a power supply that I made. But I would like to take out some components. This fuse and the adjustable port and the LED. Since it would be in an enclosure, I would take out these things and run a longer wire to put it where I need. So with all that said, let me see if taking out these components will be successful. I would be applying some paste to it first. Put this here on the LED. This is my soldering wick. Put some solder on the iron. This is one. The next one would be the fuse. Let me put some flux onto it, and I'll also put some flux onto the port. I got this. Then now I would be taking out the pot, add some more solder. This is it. I've got the three of them out. Let me make sure I stay in the view of the camera. This is it. I've got everything out, so let me that's the fuse extension for the fuse. I've soldered the fuse wire. Now I'm going to do the pot. This is this little gadget. I'm putting some flux on. making sure that it gone down . Give it enough heat so it will go down. So this side is set. This is for the pot. This is the fuse. And right now this here is for the fan, and this one is this one here is the LED. The LED and the fan. So let me get the one for the fan. I'm going to put some flux on it. Tint the solder in iron and apply. If you hear a little humming, that's because I'm using a 12 volt solder in iron. And in the 12 volt, well, I have a 13 volt regulator. I put a fan into it. That anytime it gets hot, the fan comes on to cool it out. So I've done the header for the fan. Now I'm going to do the LED. Let me put some flux onto it. Everything I used in this video, I'll have a link in the description below. If you purchase from me, I'll get a small commission at no extra cost to you. This is it. This is for the port, but I'll be using one of those right here, which I already have it on the power supply. I'll be putting the fuse at the back of the power supply. I'll be placing this fan right here, connecting to that. If you find this video was helpful, please like, share, and comment. In the other video, I will show the testing of it, and then I'll also do another video to put it into the power supply, removing the LM2596 and putting it in place of the LM2596. Thank you. Until the next one.